I'm going to start off with talking about what do customers want. Okay. How many of y'all are developers here? Okay. How many bloggers? Okay. Good number of bloggers. Right. So whether you're a developer, whether you're a blogger, whether you own a product, you know, you're selling a theme, you're selling a plugin. If you're dealing with human beings, you're in the people business. You are dealing with customers, whether you like it or not. Developers tend to like, you know what, I can do my technical stuff, but I don't want to talk to customers. I don't know how to deal with them, right? So whatever you're doing, fortunately or unfortunately, you have to love people, right? And it has to show. So we're going to talk about why you should bother, right? So there's some, you know, scary statistics there, as you can tell. So it takes 12 positive experiences to make up for one negative experience. So you really don't want to piss off your customers, right? It's so much easier to sell to your existing customers. I mean, if you take me, you know, I'm like, if I like a store and I walk in and, you know, the shopkeeper's nice to me, I end up just going there. Even if it's farther away from my home, I'll make that walk and I will actually go there and buy every day. It's as simple as that. Okay, this is the good news, right? 1 million people, they look at tweets about customer service. 80% of those customer service tweets are negative. But believe me, this is the good news, okay? Because 96% of customers who are unhappy are not even going to tell you about it, right? That is the bad news. And the really, really, really bad news is 91% of them will not bother coming back. They're not going to tell you. They're going to say, yeah, whatever. Here's your money. Go home or whatever. And they're not even, they're going to be nice. You know, most people are afraid or they hesitate or they say, you know what, it didn't work out. I'll move on. I'm not going to waste more time in trying to explain to this guy why I'm unhappy. Right? So now that you're scared, yeah? I'm hoping you're listening. And, yeah, it is always, always personal. It's a cheesy dialogue from a lot of movies, I think Jaws or something, but it is true. You have to treat a person like a number. No, not like a number, like a person, right? If you treat every single customer as if that customer is giving you $1 million, one day, one of them will give you $1 million. Believe me, right? Now, and it's always personal. You are not going to buy from somebody you don't like, right? So there's this, I don't know, how many of you are from Pune? Okay, then I won't name the store. But there's this store, okay, in Pune, where you get awesome paneer, okay, cottage cheese, for those who don't know paneer, right? You get amazing melt-in-the-mouth paneer, okay? But the guy who owns the store, he's like a grumpy, rude fellow. If you don't have change, he'll tell you to get lost. Even after he's packed your stuff and you're like begging, please give me some change. Okay, keep the change, just give it to me. And he won't give it to you. I've got umpteen number of cases like this, you know, where he's been rude to people. So I don't go to him. I send my husband, but that's a different story. Somehow people are nicer to him, I don't know why. But the moral of the story is, if you're not nice, you may have a fantastic product. People are not going to buy from you. They're coming to you because of the experience, the entire, you know, the whole pleasant experience, right? So this is another thing. People have to have faith, okay? Faith that you will deliver, confidence, trust, honesty. And when I say they have to have faith, I mean your customers have to have faith. It begins with you having faith in yourself. If you believe in yourself, it will show. Trust me, if you don't know your stuff and you're like, I don't know, I'm somehow going to pull this off, it will show. And if you have the right attitude and you strongly believe in saying, look, maybe I don't know, but I'm going to find out and I'm going to give my very best to this customer, it will show. And that's all that this means. You don't have to come up with hi-fi words or something to reinforce this. All you have to do is believe in yourself. Right. The other thing the customers look for is friction-free interaction. Absolutely friction-free. As in, with every single step that you add to the customer's experience of, you know, coming to your site, looking through, the products, buying stuff, checking out, paying for stuff. It all sort of adds to their whole experience. Okay? So, can you foresee, for example, if somebody buys a plugin from you, you know that the first thing they're going to do is install it. So, when you send them the order details or the download details, all you need to do is stick a note which says, here's how you install it. If you get stuck, here's what you do to get help. So these are simple, no, seemingly no-brainer things that you can do to make the whole customer experience smooth. So say for example, supposing I was selling sofas, for example, okay? And I'm selling sofas and Alex walks in. Alex, you're on. Just when you were running out. Yeah, so Alex walks in and he says, I want to buy a sofa, Shilpa, but how much does it cost? And I say, you know what, it costs 10,000. So he says, I only have 7,000. Can you give it to me for 7,000? So I say, okay, I'll give it to you, but you know what, you'll have to take it home. So he says, yeah, whatever, just give it to me for 7,000. I love the sofa. So I say, okay, good deal for me. I don't have to deliver it home. So I save money, he saves money, we are all happy. He takes it home. No, he doesn't. He decides to take him home. So he calls up Sanat, he calls up Karthik, he calls up Thompson, he calls up and he says, you know what, I have to carry this sofa home. Okay? He decides all we have to do is stick it into the elevator. He somehow manages to dump it in Karthik's Innova, okay, this sofa. Somehow, it's sticking out. He reaches home, he discovers he can't put it into the elevator. And now they have to carry it 3 floors. Okay? So these 4 guys, after 4 steps, you know, of carrying that sofa, he's lost his friends for sure, but more than anything else, that joy of saving 3,000 rupees is long forgotten. I don't gain with this, because in the end, that experience is such a rotten customer experience, because yes, I was honest and I said, look, I'm giving you 3,000 rupees off, but you have to take it home. Does he remember that? No. All he's telling is, I shouldn't have bought this sofa. That's all he's going on telling himself. So it, at whatever cost, even if the customer doesn't realize that there's going to be friction, you have to be extremely aware of that friction. If it means charging more, do that. Because people will pay as long as the experience is pleasant. It's not about the money that they will remember. What they will remember is the experience. I'm going to keep using this word throughout to din it and hit you over the head with it. Because that's all that matters. Right, so customer service. Most of us in the development world, we say, you know what, customer service is the cost of doing business. I do business, so I have to deal with the customers who raise support tickets or who come back to me for help. But that's not what it is. If you have a business, say you're selling, you know, you're selling to people who are offline, they don't get to meet you, they don't see you, they just buy, pay you money and download, right? The only interaction that you will have is when they come to you for help. So, if you say you love your customers, that's such a brilliant opportunity for you to show them their love, your love, right? That's the only time they're coming to you. So, treat it as a business opportunity. It's an opportunity to say, hi, yes, what can I do for you? Versus somebody sitting somewhere and just not even ever knowing you at all, right? So, make the most of these opportunities, okay? So, I'm going to talk about some sort of real life examples which some of y'all have probably come across. So I'm going to ask questions, okay? So say for example, you call up for support service, right? And okay, you are at the receiving end, you are a support agent, and you realize, oh, you know what? I'm in the sales department, and I need to transfer to the technical team, okay? So what would you say? Somebody can just be loud enough and say. So what would you tell the customer, say for example? If you are transferring a call, nobody? Somebody? Yeah, so you would say, sorry, but I'm going to have to transfer you. And thank you so much for your patience, but I need to transfer you. So just hold on for a minute, please. Is that what you would say, most of y'all? Yes. Yeah? Have I put you all to sleep already? Or? Right? So this is what you would typically say, right? But this is not the right answer. You're saying, thank you for your patience. What patience? I'm calling you up and you're thanking me for the patience, and I'll say, yeah, yeah, you're welcome. You know what? I have nothing better to do than to hold this call, right? That's not how it works, okay? It's not nice to say, thank you for your patience. I hate that line. I absolutely hate it, right? Instead, if you say, hey, you know what? I know who can sort this out for you. I know who can solve this problem. He's right here. Can you just hang on for a minute? I'm going to transfer it to him and he'll solve this for you in a minute. Doesn't that sound better than saying, so sorry, but I have to transfer you yet again. You'll have to hold on again. And this is after they've listened to like 10 minutes of music and said, press 1 for language, press 2 for this, press 3 for that. After that, you're again transferring them. Isn't this a better, more positive answer? And the customer will be like, thank you so much. Please transfer me. Yeah, yeah, yeah. Good. Right? Yeah. And they won't have a problem explaining their whole issue again. Right? So it's such a small difference. It's such a small difference. It's the same situation and the same thing. It's not as if you're doing anything different. The action is the same. You are transferring the call. But you're putting it nicely. So much more nicely. Right? And this is the dreaded one. You get asked for a feature and you're like, this feature, I can't do this. It's going to take 3 months. So you're like, I'm really, 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 really sorry, but it won't be available for 3 months. Versus, yes, you know what? The good news is we are already working on this. It's already in the works. We are going to get this out for you. As soon as it comes out, I'm going to tell you. And it's not so hard. Stick them onto a mailing list, you know, where people are waiting to find out when the new feature comes out. That's it. Right? You don't even need hi-fi tools. Stick them onto a simple mailing list. That's it. Right? So, and plus plus. So you tell them, you know what, this is going to take 3 months, but even better, here's a workaround. It may be tedious, but it'll get your job done. Once the feature is out, great. Until then, use this. Even better. You get a new feature and you say, 3 months, 2 months, chodo, I'm not even going to do it. It is not part of my plan. We get asked, I mean, for us, we get asked so many features that are, you know, if it's like we have a completely different plugin that does nothing, that has nothing to do with the menu or the theme, we get asked for features that are related to the menu, say. So we're like, this plugin is something else completely. You know what, I mean, so we're not going to tell them that. What we do is, yes, I can see from your perspective, based on your website, I know how it can be useful for you. But you know what, this is our product objective and it doesn't really fit in, right? So it's not part of our plans. Be honest, be upfront. Instead of saying, yeah, I'll tell my technical team and, you know, we'll see, we'll just throw it over the fence and see if it comes up. So keep watching this space. Maybe it'll come up. You know, instead of keeping them hanging, be honest, be upfront, right? If you can, thank them for it. The customer has taken time to come and tell you about a feature that in all probability more people will need. Okay, so be nice to them and say, hey, look, I turned down this request. I'm so sorry, but don't let that stop you from sending in more ideas. Maybe your next one we'll accept, right? So be nice to him. So say, yeah, you are making our product relevant for the business. Even better. I can't do it. It's not part of my product plan, but maybe you want to get it customized. I don't do customizations, but here's my friend. He does customizations. Do you want to go to him? Even better. And if you can suggest an alternative product and say, look, this is completely out of our product feature range, but there's this other product which plays nice with ours, and you can use this. So much better than saying, yeah, it doesn't fit in. Thank you so much, bye-bye, right? If you don't know, when you don't know, instead of saying, I'm so sorry, I don't know, let me go back and ask. Solution for you. The whole difference between these two things, or in any interaction with your customer, is focus on the solution. It's not about you. It's not about you not knowing. It's about the customer's solution. So always, always, always focus on the solution, on how you're resolving it, and emphasize to the customer that whatever you're doing, you're working towards sorting out their problem. It's as simple as that. Reporting a bug. So this, we've been very guilty of this. You know, so we used to say, yeah, we know about this. You know what, the fix is scheduled already and it'll come out. Versus, yes, we've noted it, we are making sure it works, we are testing it thoroughly, and a release will be scheduled, and you will get to know when we, and you'll get to know when we release it. So it's simple. It's really, really, really simple. So what do customers want? What any human being wants. They ask a sensible question, they want a sensible answer. That's all they're looking for. But we somehow get squeamish and, it's a bug, it's a problem, I don't know what to do. And we somehow try to, you know, fend it off and hide under complicated answers. So keep it simple. Right, so focus on the solution, not on the problem. And take the time to share reasons. If you're not able to accept their feature or you're not able to deal with whatever they're asking for, explain to them. Most people are reasonable. They honestly are. So if you take the time to explain your stand, they will understand. Yeah, the other thing is clear closure. Wait and continue the conversation until somebody says, thank you, that's it for now, nothing else. Right? So keep going back and forth until you hear that. Don't just say, this is it, take it or leave it. Right? Yep, that's pretty much it from me.